Is it time to buy stocks? Get your fishing rod and your best bait ready. It's time for some serious bottom fishing. Let's bring in our market experts. We have CNBC contributor Zachary Karabell, River Twice Investment Research, Jeffrey Kleintop, Chief Market Strategist, LPL Financial, Peter Schiff, Euro Pacific Capital, author of the little book of Bull Moves in Bear Markets. Peter Schiff, beating that bottom, bouncing off that bottom, 8,000, plus the general market rise today. It was a pretty darn good day. Is this going to be a bull market? It may be a bull and a bear, but do you think it's a bull market? Are you buying? Would you recommend buying? Is now the time to bottom fish, my friend?
Well, you know, I'm still buying stocks. I've been buying stocks for a decade, but I still think the U.S. economy is in trouble, and I don't think the current environment is going to be bullish for U.S. stocks. I mean, at some point, nominal stock prices in the U.S. are going to rise. The price of everything is going to rise in America, but I think stock prices will rise more slowly than commodity prices or consumer good prices. But if you look around the world, particularly if you look at the Asian markets, if you look at some of the natural resource markets, they are literally giving stocks away. If you think stocks are cheap in America, you go abroad, there are stocks that are trading at 2 and 3 and 4 times earnings with 15% to 20% dividend yields. Right. There are stocks trading below the cash on their books. Right, you should be buying them with both hands.
All right, we're going to come back to that point of view. Jeff Kleintop, you know, there's interesting stuff. The 3-month Treasury bill is rising. 10-year Treasuries are now gaining on 3%. It looks like the credit freeze is thawing substantially. The Baltic Dry Index is rising, maybe a sign of a commodity reflation and resumption of world growth. The money supply is expanding rapidly. Jeff Kleintop, is it time to buy right now?
This may be the beginning of the end of the crisis. You know, you talk about 8,000 on the Dow, 800 on the S&P has seemed to be pretty firm support again and again. I think if you're looking to dollar cost average your way back into this market, looking at those levels makes a lot of sense. On Friday, we recommended LPL advisors begin to take more action to re-engage with the market, selling some foreign bonds, buying some preferred stocks here. I think those are the actions that you need to take, beginning to re-engage with the equity markets here over the course of the next several months.
Are you interested? I don't know whether you guys are doing this, but are you mid-cap and small-cap players? For example, the S&P 400 mid-cap index is the best performer since the November 20 bottom. It is up 21%, and the small caps are up 14%, and the Russell 2000 is up 17.5%. Is that a signal? Is that a signal leading the bigger caps, number one? And number two, is that just a generic signal to get in and buy?
It makes a lot of sense. Small caps always tend to lead in the early stages of the recovery. But remember, they're also more credit sensitive. So as the credit market heals, those more capital dependent companies in the small cap and mid cap area tend to do better. They're also more domestically focused. And I would differ with Peter here. I think the domestic outlook is better than what we're seeing overseas, as we see the beginning of the end of the crisis here, but only the end of the beginning of the crisis overseas. Small caps leveraged to that domestic performance. Right. That's where I'd be looking to put money.
I got to get to Zachary because you guys are going to come back. I got to finish this round. Zachary Karabell, your latest column is all about bottom fishing. So get your bait out, get your good famous rod out. Now, how optimistic are you, Zachary?
You know, on the fate of the U.S. economy for the next year, I'm not particularly optimistic. But again, I don't think you need to have a U.S. economy to recover to this be a good time to get into U.S. markets. And on the global side, you know, you do see this pickup of activity. It's unequivocal. It's been going on since late November, really. I think anticipation of some major industrial activity in China and probably some anticipation of some moderate activity in the United States. So, you know, we've been seeing that in place for all the technical analysts out there. There's been this sort of bottom formed in those areas in November, December. In fact, the weakness in the market we've seen in the past 4 weeks has been almost entirely driven by the continued collapse of the financial space, which I think actually is merited. I wouldn't say, you know, you only go into financials if you're prepared for them to go to zero.
What about techs? I'm so interested in the story, you know, because the action there has been so good. What's your take on techs, real quick?
Semiconductors are quite interesting because part of that global industrial build-out is going to demand some technology infrastructure as well as companies integrating more information technologies in order to enhance margins.
So Cisco up another 2% today. Yeah. They're up big yesterday. That's part of that infrastructure play, is it not?
Absolutely. For those large companies in particular, yeah.
All right, everybody stay where you are. You're going to come back later in the show. We got more work to do on buying right now. I think that's an investor message.